This is CRI News. I'm Xiaoyi. The Chinese president has said that upholding Marxism has been proven a correct choice in China's revolution, establishment, and reform. Xi Jinping made the remarks in a speech at a conference in Beijing to mark the 200th anniversary of the birth of Karl Marx on Friday morning.
Practice has proved that Marxism provided a powerful ideological weapon for China's revolution, establishment, and reform, creating unprecedented miracles in human history concerning the development of China, an ancient Oriental country. It is correct that Marxism was chosen by the history and the people. It is also correct that Marxism was written on the banner of the Communist Party of China, and it's also completely correct to unswervingly integrate the basic principles of Marxism with China's specific reality and adapting Marxism to the Chinese context in accordance with the changing era.
President Xi, also General Secretary of the CPC Central Committee and Chairman of the Central Military Commission, says Marxism is a theory of practice that guides people's efforts in changing the world. Chinese President Xi Jinping says China is ready to join others in playing an active role to push forward the process of political solutions to the Korean Peninsula issue. The president made the pledge during a telephone conversation with his South Korean counterpart, Moon Jae-in. Meanwhile, in a separate phone conversation with Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, Xi Jinping called for joint efforts with Japan to bring bilateral relations back on the right track. Regarding the recent political development on the Korean Peninsula, Xi Jinping and Abe say they welcome the positive momentum in inter-Korean relations. China and the United States have reached agreements on some issues in their economic and trade consultations in Beijing from Thursday to Friday. The two sides agreed that a sound and stable China-US trade relationship is crucial for both, and they are committed to resolving economic and trade issues through dialogue and consultation. The two sides had a thorough exchange of views on issues including increasing U.S. exports to China, bilateral service trade, two-way investment, protection of intellectual property rights, as well as resolving tariff and non-tariff issues. Consensus has been reached in some areas. The two sides have also agreed to set up a work mechanism to keep close communication. The U.S. delegation is led by Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin. It also includes Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross and U.S. Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer. Chinese Vice Premier Liu He has met with the U.S. delegation. The Swedish Academy says it will postpone the 2018 Nobel Prize in Literature and resume giving out the prize next year. The organization has been engulfed in controversy over sexual assault allegations since November, in the wake of the global Me Too campaign. It was reported that a local newspaper published the testimonies of 18 women claiming to have been raped, sexually assaulted, or harassed by Jean-Claude Arnault. Arnault, the French husband of Academy member and poet Katharina Frostenson, has denied the allegations. At the nation's biggest bank, very disappointing. The remark was made by Attorney General Christian Porter. The Commonwealth Bank of Australia on Wednesday confirmed that it lost the backup tapes containing details of 20 million accounts dating back 15 years. The incident took place in 2016 before laws requiring mandatory reporting of serious breaches. Porter said his office would seek to pursue legal action against the bank for the breach. China's leading electric vehicle maker BYD has announced it will team up with the U.S. hybrid corporation to develop a hydrogen fuel cells battery electric bus. The bus, the first kind using fuel cells technology, will serve Honolulu's International Airport in Hawaii. Hydrogen fuel cells, which create electricity by splitting hydrogen electrons from the protons, are believed by experts to be better than the battery cells used in most electric cars because the system is much lighter. The new bus is being developed as part of Hawaii's Clean Energy Initiative to meet sustainable energy objectives of decreasing dependency on imported oil and reducing greenhouse gas emissions. This is